Hello everyone, today is kind of a rainy day here in Sofia and perfect time to talk about coaching and consulting businesses. And what is the topic I decided to get for you today? It's about mind mapping your perfect funnel. And we all know the phrase by Russell Brunson, you are one funnel away, but actually, is this absolutely correct? And we will get more in depth today about building your funnel. And most of all, we will learn what are the key ingredients of successful funnel and what are the key metrics of getting your funnel skyrocket your business. Everyone is saying that if you have a nice, good looking funnel, you will gonna succeed with your business. But this is not quite true. It's all down to a lot of experimenting, learning from your mistake, trial and error, again, new attempts, new versions, A-B testing, comparing between different campaigns. And if we have to be honest, and we always have, it's many, many different trial and errors and many different iterations until you get one of your many funnels working seamlessly very well. And especially if you are scaling with Facebook ads, you have to be able to deliver multiple funnels and to test the waters with many different visuals, different landing pages, different sales pages, even different sales videos. And by saying this, I mean you have to constantly tweak and check. Not to be obsessed with testing. There's nothing wrong to be obsessed with testing, but not to make 100 funnels at the same time, but make few of them, 3, 5, 7, 10 funnels, run them all together, and then check and analyze the metrics, analyze the video watch time, analyze the click-through rate if you are running YouTube ads. Analyze the watch time, both in YouTube and Facebook. You can see and analyze the watch time of your ads. Analyze the link click, how many people click on your lead magnets. But the most important metric, and I'm going to say this once again, because I already said in different videos, is that the most important metric is the sale. So you have to install Google Analytics and Facebook Pixel on the delivery page after the sales process, actually on the thank you page after the checkout is successful, and only people who land there will be tracked as a conversion. And this conversion method, using sales as a conversion method, is the best way to train the machine learning, the artificial intelligence inside Facebook and Google ad network, to train them to search for people that are most possible to buy from you. Because if you train them to find you people who are most possible to join your newsletter or to give their emails, the artificial intelligence, the machine learning methods will search for such kind of people, and this may not be buyers. Especially if you are just starting, try to directly connect sales with as the main conversion method in Facebook and YouTube. You can do both platform this thing, and then search for this kind of people. Of course, if you don't have email list yet, you can bring more people into your email marketing. Why? Because with email marketing, you have the chance to get in front of these people multiple times for the price of just one click. So you get good results and good return on your ad spend, good return on investment if you get email leads. But you have to be very precise what kind of email leads you get. This is why many people are using book funnels or mini course funnels. Book funnels and mini course funnels are kind of lead generation funnels. They are not sales funnels. You are not generating money from these funnels because you are giving a free book or free mini course. Actually, not free, and I'm going to explain now in details. Small mini course or small funnel or a small mini course or small book for $1 to $10. And in all cases, you will be below zero. You will not cover your expenses, but you are generating leads a little bit more expensive than just generating leads to a freebie. If you if you put a price tag on your book or on your mini course, but this price tag is very low. So only people who are very extremely interested in this topic will click their wallet, click their PayPal and take this offer, because of course this is few clicks away. This is not so easy like just giving their email and getting the freebie. So these people will be much more interested, much more targeted and much more engaged with your content further on. And these funnels work very, very well. So keep in mind that this is one possibility to generate extremely responsive, hyper-responsive email list. Just build your email list from people who purchase your $1 to $10 ebook. This is a hack that I learned from other people who are crushing with it, and now you are learning from me. And if you implement this hack, you are generating your email list very well. If you are generating it with freebie, you have to be very careful not to magnetize freebie seekers, not to magnetize people who will never purchase from you, because there are a lot of such people. So you have to be clear with the objective of your ads and never run engagement ads. Please don't run engagement ads on YouTube and Facebook. On YouTube, there is some situations where engagement is good. You bring more people to your YouTube videos and eventually these YouTube videos start to skyrocket in organic traffic. But on Facebook, getting just engagement, and some people get engagement from Africa and Asia countries just to have more likes on their posts. These days is not a real social proof. Maybe kind of social proof. But actually, if you are not generating real leads and just likes and hearts on your post, you are spending, you are wasting your money into the thin air. So with that said, I'm concluding today. We get the first of many lessons which will be delivered over the next couple of days. The first lesson about funnels. And what is the takeaway of this lesson? Be very careful what is the objective of your funnel. The objective should be the sale, or the objective should be very precise and targeted lead generations. Stay safe and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.